Good day, everyone. We are the Group 4, and we will be tackling the cultural performances, indigenous practices, religious rites, and rituals. So, indigenous customs and rituals. But before that, let us define what is indigenous. So, the term indigenous was derived from the Latin word indigena, which means native. It was formed by combining the old Latin term indo, which means in or within, and is most often used to describe the native inhabitants of the place. According to English dictionary, the indigenous is a naturally existing in a place or country rather than arriving from another place. This term was first used in 1646. Well, according to the United Nations, the term indigenous is persons as inheritors and practitioners of unique cultures and ways of relating to people and the environment and who have retained social, economic, cultural, and political characteristics that are distinct from those of the dominant societies in which they live. Customs, on the other hand, is defined as a traditional and widely accepted way of behaving or doing something that is specific to a particular society, place, or time, while ritual refers to a religious service or other ceremony which involves a series of actions performed in a fixed order such as baptism. It is a sequence of activities involving gestures performed in a sequestered place and performed according to set sequence which may be prescribed by the traditions of a community, including a religious community, and is characterized but not defined by formalism, traditionalism, invariance, rule governance, sacred symbolism, and performance. Rituals sustain the spiritual and social life of the indigenous Filipinos, closely attuned to nature, believing in spirits that keep their environment fruitful and themselves alive. The ethnic Filipinos enact these rites almost with instrumental music, chanting, and often dancing, as part of communal life cycle, but they also serve as a popular medium of dramatic expression and entertainment that reflects the people's nature, culture, and aspirations. Despite the Philippines being colonized for almost 400 years by Western powers, the indigenous customs and rituals of our people survive among our indigenous peoples living in the hills of Luzon, Mindoro, Palawan, and Mindanao. They have developed their cultures and their unique ways of life, a part of Filipino heritage which the colonizers failed to extinguish. Reverence for the land and oral traditions are emphasized in the customs and rituals of our indigenous people, like the six ethno-linguistic peoples in the Mountain Province, popularly known as Igorots. These peoples are composed of six tribes, generally found in the four provinces, a result of the subdivision of Mountain Province in 1966. The Ibaloy and the Kankanay tribes live in Benguet, the southernmost province Ifugao. Eastern flank of the Cordillera Mountain is the domain of the Ifugaos. Kalinga Apayao, the northernmost and the most accessible of the four provinces, is the habitat of the Kalinga and Apayao tribes. And the Mountain Province, the central portion of the region, is the home of the Bontocs. These mountain tribes are loose, homogeneous groups who share enough socio-cultural traits. For the most part, their lives are lived in the villages situated next to their rice fields. They share common religious beliefs, generally animistic, and make offerings to household gods called anitos, in the course of which dancing occurs. The tribesmen dance around a sacred idol or fire in cleared areas of the villages. Ritual dances are integral part of the way of life of the indigenous people. These dances, they believe, are material world's connection to the spiritual world. Thus, they have the life cycle dances which celebrate the person's birth, baptism, courtship, wedding, and death. And their occupational dances transform defense and livelihood activities to celebratory performances. So, there are some indigenous rituals in the Philippines. In the Philippines, there are more or less 175 ethno-linguistic groups. Each of them has its own form of indigenous rituals, characterized as animistic, collectively referred to as batalism. Since these ethnolinguistic groups speak different languages, they also use different terms to describe their religious beliefs, rituals, and practices. In Bukidnon, the indigenous tribes have the Hinaklaran festival and the ritual of the Tri Datu. In the Hinaklaran, chanting and dancing around the altar are performed by women. The women dance the dogso, while the Bailan does the chanting. The rituals can last for 6 hours to assure the blessings of the spirit, a good harvest, or a good fortune.
The Pinamon ritual of the Tingmans of Abra is worship of their Anito and great god Kabulian. This ritual is a prayer for rain and everyone's well-being, led by a major referred to as Matadawa or Arugan. They pour out blood over or ties around the pinaing, bali na panila ang dugo over the eyes around the pinaing. Sa mga sa stones, usually shape found the entrance of the village sa kung mapatulang makita na sa iyan lang sa iyan village. And then, nagatukod sila na ang espiritu sa kabunian, once na mo sunod sa isang kabato, sa stones, the kaning na katulong lalaki, the main participants pray or daya or dimidimi. In kanang ginapahina ko nila ang baboy para madungog sa kwan, sa madungog sa spirito. Santa ang mga babae, nagsayang o nag-awit sa salindumay. Muna siya sa ritual sa kwan, sa Tingmans of Abra. So, discuss na ito ang na-observe sa kwan, sa Tingmans known as ritual of Bawi. They have the Bawi-Bawi as a meeting house, which is the center where the Matadawa and her assistant make big cry for the spirit to hear. So, sa niya na nagpulgan ako nga sa pinagbuhi sa may sumun ng mga babae, sila naging mo sa lain ritual na nalain nga bitawag ng Bawi. At doon na sila yung Bawi sa mga house niya, pwede mo na dawa at ito sintro. And then muna sila yung bawi-bawi usa ka mga house na bawi sintro din sa tig-alagan o gagiyan ng tapang nagpahila sa baboy ang narumog sa espiritu. Muna siya ang second ritual known as bawi. And then the third ritual is the apayas of the dawa, a ritual they observe of the same cause as the Tingmans. In this ritual, the apayas, the female Matadawa, exchange verbal chants. So, ang mga apayas, patunay dawa, usa ka ritual na inihimo alang sa samtang kapayuan sa mga Tingmans. Niini nga ritual sa mga apayas, ang babae ng alaga, nagbayway, ulitok ang mga awit. Nagkuha po sila ang mga dagong bandana, o guwasay, o no. O nag-sinisik o tubig sa masakiton. So, ilang sinisik ang tubig sa mga masakiton para daw maulian. Ang masakiton na tao o parinte, anaasa o sa swatting position, bali na sila sa swatting position while sinisikan daw ang mga tubig. And then, itaburan sa usa ka simbolikong o simbolikong habol. While naka-swatting position na ito na sakit, itabunan sila o seremonyal o simbolikong habol, itabunan sila o kagisik-isikan. Sa diyan na umayang tambal, ang tanan mo bangon ang musaya. So, success na daw ang pagtambal. Nagbangon ang tanan para mag-celebrate, bali magsaya-saya na ang tanan para mag-ipay-ipay.
So, ang mga arte sa sambales, kaya sila ang ritual para pahawal ng mga evil spirits kung nagapos o sakit sa mga tao. Ngayon ang ginawa ng ritual mo kini ang anituan. Ang anituan ang nag-participate diri kay ang mga shaman o baliw ang ilang pari-pari dito sa ilang tribo o ang mga parinti sa nagsakit. Tapos ihatapukan ang nagsakit o niya ilhang putusun o kulang ang tela. Tapos ang mga shaman o ang ilang pari-pari o ang parinti sa nagsakit kaya magdala sila o mga klase-klaseng armas sama sa mga pana para pakadlok sa mga evil spirit niya o katoy nang ibuhat kay dili successful kay ilang istorya ng mga evil spirits o kanang bali lang istorya o ginag-offeran ng mga pagkaon para masatisfy o hindi na mag-cause o sakit. Tapos ang ilang ritual kay i-declare lang nila na successful kung ang katungkulang at tela kay mabira. Tapos kung successful na ilang ritual kay mag-celebrate sila through dancing. Tapos ang ilang ginabuhat kay ang shuffling walks, shaking and skipping around. Ang mga bagubo nagagikan gyapon sila sa dapaw. Ang mga bagubo kay mga religyoso nga mga tao. Ang mga bagubo nagatuo sila nga ang pamulang manubo mao'y nagbuhat sa langit o yuta. Tapos ginatuhan po nila kini nga mao'y nagbuhat sa una na tao nga si Tuglay ug ang babae nga si Tuglibon. Ang rituals kay bali part na sila sa ilahang adlaw-adlaw nga pagkinabuhi. Ang isa ka example sa ilang rituals mao ang Ginoong. Ang Ginoong kay bali upat siya kaadlaw nga ritual. Sa pagbuhat nila sa Ginoong kay ang mga tao kay magsuot sila mga colorful nga sanina ug ubanan pod nila og mga ilang traditional nga mga ornaments or mga necklace or mga bracelets. Tapos ang Ginoong kay ginapanguluhan siya sa babae nga baylan nga ang babae nga baylan. Tapos kanang bali na ay kanang ihalad nila nga manok. Tapos ang katong dugo sa manok maotoy kanang ipahid sa tao nga nagsakit. Tapos ang katong kulang nga tela kay ilang ilabay para bali panghangyo sila sa ilang Ginoo nga tagal ug kusog ang ilang pasyente. Tapos magsundan kini sa ilang pagsayaw-sayaw niya. Bali sa ilang pagsayaw kay moapil pud ang atong tao nga nagsakit aron ma-exercise, aron siya maka-exercise ug maulian siya sa iyang sakit.
Ifugaos. Ifugaos referred to as children of earth because they live in the upland areas, especially in the mountain province. Farming dominates their life, farming as the source of their income and livelihood. During harvest, they do feast, drinking, and singing hudhud. Ifugaos traditional ethics are done. The hudhud are their traditional singing habits. When the harvest is over, a Thanksgiving feast or to honor gods is held. They celebrate to honor the gods for the good harvest and wealthy. Rice, wine, fowl, and rice cakes are offered to their gods. During Tungu, are there one of their rituals, tradition, occasions for at-home days. During Tungu, nobody is allowed to leave from their house and everyone is restricted from doing household chores. This ritual is declared with the village chief after the performance of the sacred rite called Bakit. After the Bakit tradition, the Tungu will occur where no one is allowed to leave from their home. Tungu is also declared after thunder is heard by the village after long dry spell as a sign of respect to the thunder deity, which they called Amikdul, the thunder deity of their tribe. They believe that when they heard the thunder, It resembles the coming of heavy rain. There is also another ritual done by the Ifugaos, which is the Among. When the child is born, especially if she or he is firstborn, Among is done when there is a newborn child, especially if it is the eldest child. Then, another ritual they called as Kitama. It is done when the illness persists even after the sacrificial offering was done. Kitama, a woman, the Ifugaos believe to be possessed of spirit who can identify the cause of illness, is summoned by the family of the sick person. So, Kitama is a woman or their traditional doctor. It can possess or it can sense that a sick person is possessed by an evil spirit. If Kitama has determined that the illness is possessed by the evil spirit, they will perform the ayag or the dance they called ayag. This ritual that calls back a person's spirit. So, this ayag dance is they do to recall the spirit of the ill person and to disappear the evil spirit that possess the body of the evil person.